I would say the state of the digital infrastructure is now good because of our investments in 4G. We now have in 16 cities the world's fastest network when we compare to other regions. Now what is really important is to keep investing and building it out in the rest of the country, and then secondly, work on the skills gap that still exists, because despite the fact that the UK is using the internet a lot, there is still a lot of people that don't use it regularly. So what we're doing is we're investing very, very quickly. We have a program of 1.5 billion. We have about 1,000 engineers, and we work with a lot of partners to build out the mobile internet infrastructure. So today already, we can provide speeds that are similar to what you have at home. So if you have a fiber connection, you now have that same capacity out on the street, and that is just really exciting. But what we need to do is we need to get to 98% coverage by the end of 2014, and by the end of this year we will be around 70% coverage. So that's the priority now. The priority now is to build out this fantastic network that we have right now in the major cities, in the metropolitan areas, in 85 cities and towns in the country, and build it out in the rural areas and in the more remote regions. In some of these regions, there is very little existing infrastructure. And of course, financially, it's also challenging because typically the return on investment is low. But what we have found is with 4G is you can actually provide, through a mobile signal, you can provide a good indoor broadband solution. So that's what we have trialed in Cornwall, in Cumbria, in Northern Ireland, and that is what we're rolling out. First priority is Cumbria, which we are doing as we speak, actually a part of Cumbria. And then we'll see how the uptake is and how we can roll that out further in other regions of the country. We have been on the sharp end of regulation from a mobile perspective, with roaming regulation, MTR regulation, and all of the regulation is necessary. But I think what is important is to be able to maintain the investments in this country. We need to make sure that government takes a framework into account, or build a framework which is investment friendly. Because one of the reasons that the UK was behind is because companies didn't invest enough. They invested elsewhere because the profitability in the UK is significantly lower compared to other markets. So that is key. But overall, the government has played an important role and a very constructive role in securing the mobile infrastructure that we have today. And without that, we wouldn't have been here today.